should be the ones at the top there, because they are England's players of the future. They're the ones that are going to be there in 4 years' time for the next World Cup. And who's to say it won't be fourth time lucky for England? Let's go next.
Superb sunny weather at Lord's for the first of five one-day internationals, England against Pakistan for the Texaco Trophy. Very much a rematch of the recent World Cup final in Melbourne. Slight difference, 55 overs aside this time rather than 50. And Pakistan brought to the match their all-round versatility with a couple of spinners, and England happily no longer dogged by those injuries. But the weather, as I say, was fine. It's a packed house from the start, dry and sunny all day. And the toss, in fact, was won by Javed Miandad of Pakistan. Out in the middle there with Graham Gooch, they exchanged sides. Up went the coin. And Javed Miandad decided that, having won the toss, England should bat first. Those are the teams. A slight adjustment to the England side after the World Cup, that Dermot Reeve was no longer in the side, and Ian Botham no longer opening the batting. And Pakistan, full of experience, and that leg spinner, Mushtaq Ahmed, a real threat, potentially, to England. Umpires Barry Mayer and David Shepherd, confirmation that Pakistan won the toss, are fielding. We've been joined in the commentary box this summer by Asif Iqbal, the former Pakistan captain. So let's join commentary now. In the second over, the score 7 for no wicket, Aqib Javed going to Graham Gooch.
Fine shot from Gooch. Again leg side. Is one of the big changes in Graham Gooch's batting over the last couple of years. He's running with a lot more urgency and picks up singles that he never used to bother with. And it's Aqib Javed coming into bowl to Graham Gooch. Out, and the first wicket, and Graham Gooch the man to go. Nice low catch by the wicketkeeper, and England 20 for one.
Couldn't resist once he got forward, pushing out the ball. It's almost a touch of overconfidence, really. He's had a lot of runs to his name as Graham Gooch this season, looking to be positive.
Bowler gets in nice and close there. It's a good low catch by Moeen Khan. Is he pleased? New batsman Robin Smith. Akram to Alex Stewart. Oh, dear me. And suddenly, from nowhere, Akram produces lift like that.
Aqib Javed from the nursery end.
Oh, lovely shot. Now, he gave that a real clip.
Beautiful timing.
And there was not much room there to bisect those two fielders.
Count.
Drive the opposition mad. That's half the purpose of the game.
Yes, they all count. There it is, ball outside the off stump, and Alex Stewart, trying to force off the back foot, finds the inside edge, and there it goes, beating the wicket keeper. Well, that shows frustration. It was a bit wide for Robin Smith and on the front foot, and there he was having a slash.
So, Mushtaq Ahmed. They look for two.
That's good running. That was really good running by Alex Stewart. He was running towards the danger end.
Navid Anjum is the new bowler, someone I've not seen as yet.
Yes, unfortunately I haven't seen much of him either, but Javed Mir, that rates him very high as an all-rounder.
It's in the air. Oh, that drops just wide of mid-on. Looks like Ramiz running after it.
Yes.
What a strange shot.
It's good. I think the ball is not really coming on to the back, and Robin off the back foot trying to punch it. There it is, the ball. It's trying to play it through the mid-wicket.
Firm shot.
Lovely shot.
Well, that's the best of Robin Smith.
Yes, he does.
Terrifically strong in the forearms, and he gets right to the pitch of the ball, and he starts to time it. You never call him the most tidy starter, the most fluent starter, but once he gets going, terrific power there. Oh, that was a good shot there. Complete miscue by Robin Smith. Just that drift in completely deceived Robin Smith.
Just got a touch out into the pad, and that's what they were appealing for.
That is the answer. If you're having problems with a slow bowler, your footwork must be well organised. There's Navid Anjum. That's been typical of Smith's innings so far. He's hit half a dozen off the meat of the bat, but quite a few off the edge as well. And it's going to be Asif Mushtaba. 16 extras in that 106 run total. Beautifully placed. That's excellent cricket from Alex Stewart. Half century for him. Good footwork and beautifully placed over extra cover. Gone. Stewart. Aiming to square drive and got it just a little late.
And he's got in, done all the hard work, so I'd be disappointed to get out like that. But a fine innings.
Asif Mushtaba, the man taking the catch at backward point. Navid Anjum against the run of play, taking the second wicket for Pakistan. 115 for two now. And that brings in Alan Lamb.
A little bit of spin there for the left arm spinner. Yes, it just straightened, a bit of an edge and a slight chance there.
Oh, that could have been played on back to the leg stump so easily. Six runs off the over.
Yes, an inside edge. It's a low bounce, you see. Look at the keeper getting right down. Keeper expecting the bounce of the ball. It's an inside edge, but low on the bat. was beautifully bowled, was that. Top spinner running in quite quickly. He's noticed that Robin Smith's trying to get back and watch the ball off the pitch, watch the slow turn and then play it. Try to outmanoeuvre him.
Well, tossed up, but what a hammer blow that was. Buys given, which made a bit of a nonsense of the wicketkeeper's appeal. Yes, and England on target there for a huge score. Still over 20 overs left, from which they could expect to be scoring over 6 runs and over. And that's Robin Smith's 50. 43rd One Day International. This is his 11th score of over 50. Again, it shows the lack of bounce there. Robin Smith, one of the best cutters and square drivers in the game, looking to thump that away wide of cover's left hand, and the ball's only got up about half stump height.
Sort of feeling typifies the Pakistan performance this morning. A wide ball by Mushtaq allows Alan Lamb to sweep it. And whenever he bowls straight, the leg spinner, they struggle to get a run. And then he's frustrated by this piece of fielding that displeased him.
Really had to move there. The survival hack came in very quickly, gathered in on his right hand side, and it was a good throw. So strong in that area on the offside. Must be paid to give him anything short. The bowlers, like Mervyn Hughes, have found out the same thing.
Magnificent shot. Full control. He saw it. It was shot exactly where he wanted it.
Asif Mushtaba is the bowler from the pavilion end. And this is where the run surge would come. In the 17 overs to be bowled after lunch. It's a typical Alan Lamb stroke.
Magnificent shot. He got into the position and he played it exactly where he wanted.
Idea of the acceleration of the England side comes from the fact that their first 50 came from 88 balls, second from 55, then 66, and the last 50 to bring up to 200 came from just 46 balls. Beautifully placed once again by Robin Smith, way over extra cover, a favoured stroke of each of these batsmen. The bowler is Asif Mushtaba, left arm spin from the pavilion end.
And certainly Robin Smith and Alan Lamb are putting all their efforts in getting this run rate going up and up. Pakistan is certainly under pressure right now.
once again, excellent footwork.
This being the weak link in the bowling, but England batsmen are making the best of it, and Robin Smith in particular is making sure that Asif Mushtaba doesn't get away without giving away quite a few runs.
That is, he's found the outside edge, or in the way Robin Smith is looking at the bat, if they had been right at the very end of the blade. And Akib Javed has struck again. He had Gooch's wicket early on. Now he has Robin Smith, and England 213 for the loss of 3 wickets. A setback for them, but still in with the chance of a big total.
Yes, with wickets in hand, I think this is what the English batsmen will try and do. They'll go for the shots. And Robin Smith, as we saw, played a magnificent inning. 85 off only 117 balls.
213 for 3 now. Neil Fairbrother. And England 213 for the loss of 3 wickets. A setback for them, but still in with the chance of a big total.
Yes, with wickets in hand, I think this is what the English batsmen will try and do. They'll go for the shots. And Robin Smith, as we saw, played a magnificent inning. 85 off only 117 balls.
213 for 3 now. Neil Fairbrother is the new batsman. Good running between the wickets. Lamb's had a few problems this summer so far with groin and hamstring injuries, but now he's reached a half century. It's beautifully played. It was rather an odd, slower ball. Even though the boundary was saved, they'll run 4. That was the slowest of all slower balls. No subtle variation there. And Fairbrother checked and checked, and waited, then finally played the stroke. What a great catch. That is an astounding catch by the Pakistan captain.
Yes.
Bad back and all. He's taken an absolute blinder.
Yes, and certainly this is what Pakistan needed at this stage, because Alan Lamb well set in. And Naveed Anjum has got 2 overs to go, certainly the weakest of the bowlers left to bowl their overs. Shot one, Alan Lamb got a good hold of it. He hit it pretty hard, in fact, but what a marvellous catch, and a very good knock by Alan Lamb.
.238 for 4. Fairbrother is unbeaten on 12. And Graham Hick, well, perhaps there will be room for all the batsmen now the breakthrough has been made. There's Chris Lewis.
The difficult thing, of course, is playing against people like Wasamakum. Their pace, they tend to try and charge down the wicket to, well, really slog, shall we say, at this stage. That's when the real danger of being hit occurs, because you're going down the wicket and it slips running short at you, and you're not really in a position to play the correct shot then.
Oh, and look at that. The perfect in-swinging Yorker. How many times we saw that in Australia in the World Cup? And really, you think that from round the wicket and with that slanting in-swing that he can't get anybody LBW and therefore bowl them. But this man is a master of that sort of full-length Yorker delivery.
Well, this is as near perfection as you can get at the death. Big in-swinger right in the block hole, just past the popping crease. And Hick completely deceived. We may well have been deceived in any kind of cricket by that delivery.
A tremendous delivery. Quick, swinging in, right into the ball.
And that's who he brings to the crease, Ian Burton. Boundary for since the 46th over, and we're in the 53rd, and England needed that. Still a commanding score, but they really will be disappointed if they don't top 280. First one that both in really middled. Perishing for the good of the cause. Nicely caught. Akib Javed again picks up the wicket, and England 265 for 6, and that's the end of Fairbrother for 25.
Well, useful innings by Fairbrother, a bit unlucky here. A yard out of the side of the field, it would be a 4.
Chris Lewis. Just 10 balls of the innings left. Is how Fairbrother got out. Loves to play square on the offside and didn't pick the right angle. Well, I'm not sure how far that missed by, but I don't think Lewis was ever in any real danger.
Missing leg stick, and well, Chris Lewis there.
It missing really leg stick that end as well, right? 55th and final over. The end of the England innings, 55 overs, 278 for 6.
A very brisk start indeed by Alex Stewart, his 50 coming off 69 balls, and then two excellent partnerships. Stewart and Smith put on 95, Smith and Lamb put on 98, both at a brisk tempo. And so England fairly hurtled along until they were slightly contained towards the end, but 278 for 6 was a formidable total. As for Pakistan's bowling, well, Wasim Akram was truly superb. Maybe a clue to his form during the summer. 1 for 39 off 11 overs, and just when the slog was on towards the end, he removed England batsmen and definitely contained them. So Pakistan needed 279 runs to win. 55 overs, remember, and a run rate required of 5.07. Let's join them now. The second ball of the second over, Derek Pringle, bowling to Ramiz Raja.
It's got to be in straight away. Well, already this is something of a bizarre innings. Ball changing. A slightly slower ball from Pringle to Ramiz Raja, who's dollied it back to him. First wicket down, with Pakistan needing in all 279 for victory, and they're not on the board yet.
Well, this is definitely what Pakistan didn't need. He stops his shot, almost placed too soon. The ball just holding up a little bit.
I suppose you could say it's coming up the hill at Lord's, up the slope, so it's quite a good delivery to hold its line. But he certainly played much too soon, a little dolly catch back to Derek Pringle.
The innings took 7 minutes, but that's a little bit of an illusion, because he's only faced two balls and half the time the umpires are off the field. That's a fluent stroke. The first ball he's received from Pringle. Not quite a half volley on leg stump, but not far away from it.
Salim on your left should have had plenty of practice in the nets against Derek Pringle while he was playing for Essex last season.
That's the sort of stroke I was talking about. The left-hander, and that's a good over for Pakistan. They need more than five and over. It's 11 for one.
Well, this is an impressive on drive. Full flow of the bat, excellent timing, placement good, and the ball sped away.
And the last two overs, two shots of real class. One from Amir Sohail and that one from Salim Malik.
Well, this is a quality pull shot. Just waited for the ball in position very early. Philip De Freitas's normal length is just a touch short.
And that sort of stroke will reduce the target quite dramatically.
Well, Derek Pringle's natural ball is the outswinger to a right-hander, which is an in-swinger to the left-hander, just swinging into his pads, and he gets it round about middle, and on leg stump. He's going to whip it away, and it really is a whipping shot.
And it's that sort of stroke that will make it a bit easier for Javed Mir and Adnish.
Well, this is a glorious shot. Lovely, wristy, straight drive. Just lets the ball come and just a little flick of the wrist.
That's well fielded. It's one of the reasons Neil Fairbrother is chosen in this England side and was taken on the World Cup tour. He's a brilliant fielder, apart from being a very good batsman. It's 34 for one. Pringle is gone, removed from the attack. Chris Lewis comes on at the pavilion end. And he's got away with it. It's the sort of player Amir Sohail is. Salim Malik would give him a burst from the non-striker's end.
Well, there's no real need for this. He's been playing quite beautifully. Lovely onside shot. Beautiful stroke that.
Chris Lewis now, his third over from the pavilion end. Oh, he scored him.
Oh, he rubs his arm.
Chris Lewis thinks it was off the bat. Ian Botham caught it. How is that, says Botham?
Yes, it has got a smile on his face, and there it is. We'll be able to see it now.
Now, was it not Ian Botham and Amir Sohail who had a word or two?
Yes, I was World just... Well, I was going to mention something about when you know that it didn't hit the bat, you don't appeal. whereas here everybody was appealing except that Amer showed where it hit and the umpire agreed with him.
Well, stopped.
Graham Hick.
Hi, move quickly then.
Firm shot, played quite firmly. And so far, England has really saved quite a lot of runs with some brilliant piece of fielding.
A slow one, big shot for OBW. Luckily, David Shepherd's a man with huge experience. And I see Chris Lewis hopping up and down, jumping, running down the middle of the pitch. Yes. It's a bit of a leg spinner, I think he tried. So Ian Botham now has the ball. There'll be, no doubt, I see, for a huge debate as to whether he should be selected for the test team.
The impression one gets is now Ian is considered for one-day cricket.
And he's got his wicket, his first over. You really can't keep Ian Botham's name off the scorecard. It's incredible. Pakistan's second wicket goes down. That of Salim Malik caught Alex Stewart, Boldy and both number 24, and a real danger man is removed.
Yes, certainly he was, there's no doubt about it. And here Ian just coming and bowling just within himself, and Salim trying to run down the ball in that vacant area for a single.
Botham takes his spell at slip, but in comes his old adversary Javed Miandad. 55 for 2, the Pakistan score, as Chris Lewis comes in. And this time, Amer Sohail has found lovely gap at mid-wicket. He has been striking the ball to fielders very cleanly, but this time through the middle and four runs.
Derek Pringle back, 3 overs for 23. Doesn't happen too often. Batsman in any trouble. In fact, there was even a little bit of variation of direction of running there from the left-hander Sohail. He made sure that he was going to be in, just veered away a little bit. Oh, and he's out. Gone. Nicely picked up. Graham Hick there and not keeping it down. But a fine catch and an important wicket, and Pakistan now 74 for 3. Javed Miandad out for 7.
Miandad on his way back to pavilion, but it was a really nothing sort of a ball going down the leg side. It's the sort of ball that a batsman's looking for. Looking for 4 runs there, but just failed to get on top of it. Didn't quite keep it down, but a good catch.
New batsman, Inzamam Ul-Haq, and one of the most exciting young talents in world cricket. Well, a good position taken up by umpire Mayer. He hadn't got time to get too far away from the stumps, and in fact, we shall see that he was only about 3 yards away from the stumps, but bang in line.
Yes, it was certainly always going to be tight. Really under pressure there. Very, very tight indeed.
This is close. In fact, it wasn't, because it was a comfortable run out in the end. Oh, what a turnaround that's been. And that's the sort of thing that does nothing for the morale of a dressing room. So Hell goes. And 78 for 4.
And I think one of the great things about this was the way Botham gathered the ball. The hard throw coming in first bounce.
He gathered it beautifully there, and, well, you can see he's still just short and the wicket already broken.
Asif Mushtaba, the new batsman, and a terrific lot of responsibility now with him and young Inzamam at the other end, because Pakistan now in desperate need for inspiration and some batting, magical batting from somebody. Got it, claiming it, and being given. Inzamam didn't want to know, Botham did, and so in the end did umpire Mayer. And an alert bit of fielding by Botham. He'd heard or seen the nick, he was down there for it, and whatever Inzamam might have thought, nobody else was in much doubt that mattered, and that really is a body blow.
Yes, it could be nothing. Pad first, and onto the bat on the way up after it hit the pad.
Wasim Akram, and effectively Pakistan's last hope of making something of this match. And we'll again see this one from Botham slanting in, and as Ray Illingworth said, possibly bat first, pad first, and then Botham quite happy that there was contact with bat. Close as well. This is a duel that's not without its drama. The calling there seemed almost non-existent. There was a couple of looks and glances, and finally little Mushtaba's wandered back, but he only just made it, or would he have done? Not sure he would. Neat little shots. Well, a better throw, and that might have been close. Just a touch of hesitation at the end of the second run as to whether there should be a third. And all but got through. It may have just been a little bit of bat on it. Whatever it was, Wasim Akram survives. So do Pakistan. Oh yes, just a little bit of bat before it got through onto the bat and could easily have squeezed through the gates.
Afraid it's the bowler. Oh, trouble here. Oh, they got out of it.
Well, not only was there a mix-up by the batsman, you'll see there's almost a mix-up with the England fielders. They had the Chris Lewis picks it up, has it ready to throw in, and Philip de Freitas doesn't quite get back quick enough, and the throw comes in lobbed.
Bench in bowling and in tactics, spin introduced now. Richard Illingworth, the left arm spin bowler, coming on from the nursery end. That's good feeling. Look, for all the world, there'd be two in that, and the batsmen didn't muck around. They moved very quickly for the first.
Well, an opportunity there for a caught and bowl, I think. See him come dancing down the pitch, drives it. And he's usually got a good pair of hands, as Richard Illingworth.
And that'll do nicely. Beautiful deflection down the leg side.
In the position that Pakistan is in at the moment, they can't really afford to lose more wickets. And these two established reasonable partnership.
I'll take a look at this and take a look at Alan Lamb at mid-wicket.
Bevan, a great catch.
Oh. Just curving away, lovely shot, what that, wasn't it? Yes, no, the classical run-out call.
Well, what can one say? I think these two haven't batted together for a long time. And certainly this was something which, certainly if the youngsters are watching, they should totally ignore it.
Four runs, 50 partnership. For the moment, Pakistan wriggle off the hook. It's a beautiful stroke. Well, that's four runs. Went square on the offside. I thought for a moment he was aiming towards extra cover. Anyway, it went through point, and that's four runs.
Yes, I think they have now decided that it's time they have to go for these boundaries, because singles are not going to help. And Graham Gooch was keeping five in the circle, but now he has dropped one to the boundary.
Oh, he dropped it. Graham Gooch at cover.
Well, there it is. I mean, the batsmen are going for their shots now, and this one at a good height to Graham, just to his left.
Oh! Well, that was a bit of a giveaway by Ian Botham. He took two or three Gulliver strides towards that ball, never really in the tempo of making a run out, and then absolutely hurled it at the stumps. Here he comes, big strides, and was it worth it? No, he's well in. Nice shot. Alex Stewart has to do all the running down there. They're on the third. They may turn for four. No, they'll settle for that. Beautiful late cut by Asif.
With no third man there, Asif, knowing that there's a vacant position, played it very delicately.
And the Pakistan innings has really limped along from the start. It was 0-1 at the start when Ramiz Raja was out. 150's up.
Out. Beautifully bowled. Alex Stewart did the necessary, and Illingworth earned that. No criticism of Wasim Akram, and he's a terrific striker of the ball. He had to have a dart at Illingworth. He's the one that he was looking for fours and sixes from, but Illingworth spotted, saw him coming, and the end of a very useful partnership, which has added 83, more than doubled the score. Hit that, but he's hit it to the wrong man, and that's the seventh wicket. Graham Hick the catcher, Derek Pringle the bowler, Navid Anjum the man out for three, and 164 for seven.
Well, just really a bit of a slog across the line, and say picking the wrong man, Graham Hick. He's got a lovely pair of hands, doesn't drop very many.
Wicketkeeper of Pakistan, Moeen Khan. It was 50. Creditable efforts.
In fact, Graham Hick is now going to be given a turn with his off-spinners.
He's picked up a wicket straight away. Asif Mushtaba has gone. For a moment, it looked as though Robin Smith might overrun that ball. Grabbed it in the end, and that is the eighth wicket down. Asif Mushtaba caught Smith bowled Hick for 52 from 81 balls. Mushtaq Ahmed is the new batsman, and Robin Smith from front on now, almost getting a little bit too far. And he's gone. Moeen Khan is gone. Pringle picks up another wicket. And that's a good effort from Dirk Pringle because he took a hammering early on. He's come back very well. And in picking up that wicket, that of Moeen Khan, pretty much off the face of the bat through to Alex Stewart, Dirk Pringle has put up his best ever limited overs international bowling figures. First time he's taken four wickets. Has picked up the last wicket. Akif Javed is dismissed. Mushtaq Ahmed remains unbeaten. All out for 199 Pakistan. And this is the last wicket. Graham Hick the bowler. Akif Javed the man dismissed.
With the top five Pakistan failing, there were no serious foundations laid, and it was left to Asif Mushtaba and Wasim Akram in a partnership of 83 to raise the tempo, but they never quite got up to the 8 runs per over required at that stage. So for England, it was a comfortable win, and they bowled and fielded extremely well. Philip de Freitas, excellent as ever, 9 overs, 2 maidens, 0 for 17. Good to see him in on the act. 4 wickets for Dirk Pringle, 2 for Ian Botham, 1 for Richard Illingworth, who also bowled his slow left arm extremely accurately, and Graham Hick in at the end with 2 for 7. So England win this first match by 79 runs, 278 for 6, Pakistan 199 all out. Now the winning captain, Graham Gooch, received a cheque on the balcony at the end of the match, £5,250 to the winning captain. Robin Smith was the man of the match, nominated by Tom Graydon. That's why he was named man of the match, runs 85, scoring shots 57, 4-7, and a little diagram there to the right to show where the runs all came from.
TV viewers and to those watching on